De vier niet-residerende ambassadeurs van Turkije, Namibië, Colombia en de Dominicaanse Republiek hebben vandaag hun geloofsbrieven aangeboden aan president Chandrika Prasad Santokhi. De plechtigheid vond plaats op het presidentieel paleis. Wij brengen u daarover het volgende verslag.
De militaire kapel speelde muziek ter eerbetoon aan de ambassadeurs. Deze ambassadeurs gaven elk te kennen dat de landen die zij vertegenwoordigen goede relaties hebben met Suriname. Zij verwachten deze relatie tijdens hun termijn te verdiepen en te versterken. De ambassadeurs van Turkije en Namibië bekenden heel blij te zijn om deel uit te maken van deze ceremonie en deelden graag hoe zij van plan zijn de relaties met Suriname te versterken.
Very rich country, and of course I will also promote Suriname in Turkey. They must also come to visit. So this should be reciprocal, not only one way. And I also encourage young people to look for scholarships given by Turkey. It's not only for students. There are also scholarships for public officers or for academicians. So I'm very much for an exchange of people. This would contribute a lot to our already existing friendly relations.
It is my intention as the ambassador of the Republic of Namibia to Suriname to bring these warm relations to greater heights. I will promote people-to-people contact and also cooperation between our business, trade and investment between our two countries. As you know, Suriname is endowed with a lot of resources, mineral resources. So we will work together to share some experiences in these areas and other areas of mutual interest.
De ambassadeurs van Colombia en de Dominicaanse Republiek gaven vol enthousiasme aan hoe zij de relatie met Suriname zullen bevorderen. Zo gaf de ambassadeur van Colombia aan dat diverse onderwerpen, zoals de ontwikkeling van landbouw, aangekaart zullen worden tijdens de tweede ministeriële vergadering tussen Colombia en de CARICOM op 28 januari.
We are happy to know that we are going to meet again after our first meeting in Cartagena 2 years ago. So we have several areas to work, health issues. We have been working very much, Colombia and Suriname, on health issues, and now we can continue and strengthen. So agriculture, security, health, and trade, investment, and tourism are areas that we want to work deeply. I mean, we have been working on that, but we want to strengthen all these areas.
I mentioned that, for example, trade. I mean, I think that we have a strong relationship in trade, but I think that it can be excellent extended even further. I mean, we're going in the coming month, now that I have presented credential, I hope to meet with the business community from Suriname and also have tried to facilitate interaction between both of our business community between the two countries to explore potential opportunities. And obviously at the level of government, we're going to be meeting with several ministers to look for potential collaboration and synergy in different areas, ranging from forestry to fishery to tourism and others.
Geen van de ambassadeurs heeft Suriname als standplaats. Morgen, dinsdag 9 november, zullen ook de ambassadeurs van Oostenrijk, Vietnam, Angola en Servië hun geloofsbrieven aan de president aanbieden.